Hello friends, I am Sheetal and welcome back to Target Study YouTube channel. When we talk about food technology, what exactly do we mean? So to answer this, food is basically the stuff that keeps us alive, such as plants, animals, fruits, milk, and a variety of other foods. Technology, on the other hand, is the practice of using the most up-to-date engineering methods and techniques. So, food technology is a science that encompasses all of the techniques and activities involved in storing, processing, and manufacturing food. And this science is in great demand today. Thanks to increasing demand to preserve the food items for longer periods to meet our near future demands. Just because of this, Master of Science in Food Technology course is in great demand because it belongs to that branch of science that involves the processing, preservation, preparation, selection, distribution and utilization of sheltered, nutritious and healthy nourishment. M.Sc. in Food Technology has become one of the most popular courses among the science graduate owing to its high demand in the job market and rising popularity. So today in this video, I am going to provide you details about M.Sc. Food Technology program. By the end of the video, you will definitely be aware of minute details of the course, like what exactly M.Sc. Food Technology course entails, what are the required eligibility conditions to join M.Sc. Food Technology course, what are the skills required to do M.Sc. Food Technology course, how to join M.Sc. Food Technology course, and which are the various entrance exams, what is the syllabus of M.Sc. Food Technology course, what is the fee structure of M.Sc. Food Technology course, which are the various government and private institutes offering M.Sc. Food Technology course, what are the career prospects and job opportunities after completion of M.Sc. Food Technology course, which are the top recruiters of M.Sc. Food Technology degree holders, what is the expected salary or pay package after doing M.Sc. Food Technology degree, and much more. So guys, let us start with a very basic question, and that question is, what exactly M.Sc. Food Technology course is? M.Sc. or Master of Science in Food Technology is a two-year postgraduate course pursued under science stream which provides a specialized focus on food technology and food science, which are essential to maintain proper food quality in the food manufacturing and processing sector. M.Sc. Food Technology course consists of knowledge about food, microbiology, food chemistry, enzymes in food processing, food biotechnology, etc., which provides greater depth on the food science. Now, when you are well aware of the course, you would like to know the eligibility conditions required to join M.Sc. Food Technology course. As far as educational qualification is concerned, you must have earned at least a bachelor's degree. Your bachelor's degree should be either from the fields like B.Sc. Food Technology, B.Sc. Food Science and Technology, B.Sc. in Dairy Technology, B.Tech Food Technology, or any other equivalent fields like Life Science, Biotechnology, Microbiology, Chemistry, Biology, Home Science and any other related subjects from any recognized university or college. However, some reputed food technology institutes may also demand a certain minimum percentage of marks at this level, which can be anywhere between 55 to 60%. These eligibility requirements can also vary slightly from institute to institute. Along with meeting these eligibility requirements, you must need a specific set of skills to do two-year M.Sc. Food Technology program successfully, like you must possess technical, analytical, and organizational skills. You should have problem-solving skills as well as the ability to objectively analyze data. You should be able to handle your time effectively. Besides, you should be able to conduct studies, have practical skills, and approach your work in a scientific manner. If you are really looking to do M.Sc. Food Technology course, then the knowledge of its admission process is a must. The admission process of M.Sc. Food Technology course varies from institute to institute, as various institutes have their own admission process. As some institutes provide admission to their M.Sc. Food Technology program on the basis of marks obtained in the aspiring student's qualifying class. But most of the reputed food technology institutes provide admission on the basis of rank secured in the entrance exam conducted at institute, university or state level entrance exams. Some of the reputed M.Sc. Food Technology entrance exams that you can think to take are Central Food Technology Research Institute entrance examination, Graduate Aptitude Test examination and Maharishi Dayanand University Common Entrance Exam. Now let me tell you about the syllabus of M.Sc. Food Technology course. The 2 years full-time M.Sc. Food Technology course is split into 4 semesters, each lasting 6 months. In M.Sc. Food Technology Semester 1, you will study subjects like Food Chemistry, Food Microbiology, Principles of Food Engineering, Principle of Food Processing and Preservation, Lab 1 for Food Microbiology, Lab 2 for Food Preservation and Open Elective 1. Whereas, M.Sc. Food Technology Semester 2 consists of subjects like Dairy Technology, The Technology of Fruits and Vegetables, Unit Operations in Food Processing, Lab 3 for Dairy Technology, Lab 4 for Fruits and Vegetables Analysis and Program Elective 1. M.Sc. Food Technology Semester 3 usually consists of subjects like Technology of Cereals, Technology of Meat, Fish and Poultry, Lab 5 for Chemistry and Technology of Cereals, Program Elective 2 and In-Plant Training. In M.Sc. Food Technology Semester 4, you study subjects like Program Elective 3, Research Project and Seminar etc. Subjects that you can choose from Program Electives are such as, in Program Elective 1, you can have subjects like Packaging Technology, Pulses and Oilseed Technology and Technology of Beverages. Whereas in Program Elective 2, you can have subjects like Food Additives, Food Standards and Quality Assurance and Nutrition and Health. In Program Elective 3, you can have subjects like Bioprocess Technology and Food Biotechnology. Now let me tell you about some of the top M.Sc. Food Technology Institutes in India. If you are looking for some of the best government institutes, then you can go for Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar, Mahatma Gandhi University, Kerala, Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, and Punjab Agricultural University, Ludhiana. And if you want to join some of the best private institutes, then you can go for Amity University, Jaipur, Birla Institute of Technology, Ranchi, Lovely Professional University, Jalandhar, and Parul University, Vadodara, etc. Now you must be curious to know about the M.Sc. Food Technology course fee structure. The average fee for the M.Sc. Food Technology course in government institutes or universities may range between ₹50,000 to ₹1 lakh per annum, while the course fee for the same course in some of the reputed private universities may be somewhere between ₹2 lakh to ₹3.5 lakhs annually. This fee structure may vary from university to university and from time to time. So it is always advisable to go through the latest admission notification issued by the institute to have knowledge of exact amount of the fee charged by any particular institution. Now here are the career prospects and job opportunities after M.Sc. Food Technology course. There are lucrative career opportunities in both the public and private sectors after you complete your M.Sc. Food Technology degree program. Postgraduates with a degree in food technology may find work in a variety of industries including food packaging companies, food processing companies, food manufacturing industries and food science laboratories etc. as a food technologist, food packaging manager, laboratory supervisor, production manager, purchasing manager, product or process development scientist, technical brewer, nutritionist and quality assurance manager etc. Postgraduates with a master's degree in food technology can also opt for a career as a food journalist or content writers with various print and electronic media. If you are more inclined towards academics, then you can go for higher degrees like PhD and look for employment as an educationist in educational institutions, besides going for research work in various government and private research facilities. Some of the top recruiters that you can think of joining after completing your M.Sc. Food Technology are Amul, Agrotech Foods, Cadbury Limited, Coca-Cola India Limited, Dabur India Limited, Food Corporation of India, Gits Food Products Private Limited, Hindustan Lever Limited, Milk Food, MTR Foods Limited, Nestle India Private Limited, Parle Products Private Limited, and PepsiCo India Holdings etc. Now the most frequently asked question is, what are the proposed pay packages or salaries after completing M.Sc. Food Technology course? The Master of Science in Food Technology degree holder can expect to earn anything between ₹3.6 to ₹4.8 lakhs annually as a starting salary. With relevant industry experience and expertise in the field, the salary can increase as high as ₹8 lakh to ₹12 lakhs in few years' time. Whereas the salary structure in the government sector depends upon the prevailing pay scale in the particular state or central government department. But mind you, these pay packages are also quite attractive that comes with loads of perks and remuneration along with the status attached with the position in the government sector. So at the end of this video, I would like to mention that food technology as a career option is growing at a very fast pace. If you are inclined towards this field, then this master's degree in food technology can really help you enter the field with a bang. That's all to know about the Master of Science in Food Technology program. I hope you find this video informative. If it is really so, click the like button. Do press the bell icon to receive automatic notification. We'll be back with more videos on such interesting subjects. Till then, have a nice time. Thank you for watching.